The vegetable pictured here with this dainty little pink flower is Phaseolus vulgaris, the bean. Here you can see the growth form of beans, and beans have quite a variety in growth habit. They can get 2 to 15 feet tall, they can trail along the ground, they can grow in a bush form, or they can climb as a vine, and if they're climbing, they're going to climb via tendrils. Beans have trifoliate leaves, so trifoliately compound leaves, which means that this whole thing is one leaf. So a compound leaf with three leaflets, and you'll notice that the leaf margins are entire, so that's different from some of the other compound leaves we've had in vegetables, and the leaflets are broadly ovate in shape. Here you can see what a bean flower looks like. It has zygomorphic or bilateral symmetry, and it is a pea-like flower again with that top flag petal, the bottom lip petal, and the two keel petals if you look closely at it. It can vary in color from pink to white to yellow to red, depending on the bean cultivar. And then of course we have the fruits. So we have an elongate, almost boat-shaped, zygomorphically symmetrical fruit. And again, as with so many of our vegetables, there is a lot of variety in the part we eat because that's what they're bred for. So you can find green beans, yellow beans, red beans, purple beans. The bean on the left has sort of a green bean with purple modeling on it, so a lot of variety in color, but typically the same elongated shape, although sometimes it may be a little more curled, as you see in the picture in the right here. And that concludes our discussion of Phaseolus vulgaris, the bean.